Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for joining us today for this video update from the National March for Life Organizing Committee. We are exactly 1 month to go to the big event, the March for Life here in Canada. My name is Matt Wojciechowski. I'm the Vice President of Campaign Life Coalition and a member of the March for Life Organizing Committee. I'm joined today by my colleagues, National Organizer Debbie Duval, CLC Youth's Coordinator Josie Lutke, and Dunn Media's Kevin Dunn, who is helping us out again this year in a big way to produce a lot of wonderful, wonderful March for Life programming online. Today, we are also joined by a very special guest, the one and only David Bewright, founder of 40 Days for Life, and in my opinion, the pro-life movement's favorite spokesperson. Thank you, David, for joining us today.
Matt, it is such an honor to be with you. I am so excited. I can't believe we're counting down and then the big Canadian March for Life. It's going to be amazing.
See, look at this. I'm already hyped just listening to him. I'm going to dive right in. David, you have been to the March for Life in Canada on many occasions. You've been a Rose Dinner keynote speaker. You've been a youth conference keynote speaker. You've spoken on the Hill to thousands of people. You've pretty much done it all. This year, however, we've asked you to be the master of ceremonies for the annual Rose Dinner. And we're super grateful that you accepted the offer. So what can people expect this year?
Well, you know, Matt, I am so excited about the Canadian March for Life. As you said, I've been there many times, and it's one of my favorite pro-life events I've ever been to. So I've traveled to more than 650 cities across all 50 American states and dozens of other countries. But there's something really unique and special about the National March for Life in Canada. And I think it's the camaraderie that brings so many people together. And I think it's the fact that you are coming together amidst an environment that is consistently challenging for advancing the cause of life. And so when I heard the theme for this year's March for Life, "You Are Not Alone," I thought that was the perfect theme. And for all of us to recognize that we come together, some yes in person and many more virtually, coming together because we can't end abortion and other attacks against human life on our own. We have to do it together. And it's not just one person, it's not just one organization, it's the entirety of the pro-life movement. So as we come together, some on the Hill in Ottawa and others joining together virtually for the March for Life and then for the Rose Dinner, we're going to understand that we are all in this together. I live in the States. I work with pro-lifers all around the world. But we are all, just like the many parts of the body of Christ coming together as one body, so too the pro-life movement is made up of many, many diverse parts, different organizations, different charisms, different personalities. But this is our one moment to come together as one unified voice, to send a message across Canada that the pro-life movement is strong, is young, is vibrant, and that we are going to press forward until that day when no more children die and no more women cry. And it's not just you and me and those who are here on this organizing call as we're getting ready to count down for this, but also you'll be joined by other people, not even only from just across Canada, but from around the world, uniting together as one voice. As March for Life activities happen in cities and nations around the world, but we are focusing our attention on May 13th on Canada and what you are going to accomplish, not alone, but together with so many others. So that's what we'll be doing at the March. That's what we'll be doing at the Rose Dinner. And I cannot wait. I am so excited for our time together.
Definitely. And I keep saying that the pro-life movement, the March for Life, it really is a global movement, right? You have marches all around the world. And this will be, I believe, the 24th National March for Life in Canada. So we've come a long way. This year's Rose Dinner will have all the same elements that we've grown to love. But in this year's in particular, there will be a special surprise, I guess. Maybe Kevin, would you like to talk about a bit about what people can expect to see this year at the virtual Rose Dinner?
Thanks, Matt. Yes, we're very excited about this year's Rose Dinner. Not only do we have David Bewright, who is going to be our master of ceremonies. So happy that you're with us, David. We've got an interesting panel discussion that's going to happen. Instead of your traditional keynote speaker, we have three international speakers who are going to be part of a panel discussing the ever-growing hostility towards those who stand against so-called choice and autonomy. We hear these words a lot. In particular, though, the topic of discussion is the pro-life movement in a cancel culture. Our three speakers are Kristen Hawkins from Students for Life America, Father Deacon Andrew Bennett, former Canadian Ambassador for Religious Freedom, and Tanya Granig Allen, political commentator. I will be your moderator for this part of the evening, which I'm very much looking forward to. Part of the evening, this section of the evening, we'll have special video segments addressing various themes such as the cancel culture in politics, big tech social media, and pro-life activism in the public square. People who have sent us videos, these are victims of the cancel culture themselves. And I hesitate to call them victims because these are stalwart people who are out there promoting the message, the pro-life message, in a clear, concise, powerful manner, willing to take what comes at them. In a lot of cases, sometimes it's a cancellation altogether. I know Kristen has had some of her pamphlets burned at events. This is just crazy. We should be engaging in discussion. We should have a situation where we can sit down and have good conversation, even if we disagree. So that is the beauty of this evening, pro-life in a cancel culture. That is the panel discussion we'll be having. And really, this is all in an attempt to bring practical advice to pro-lifers who may be feeling alone in their fight for the protection of life from conceptional natural death until natural death. I know sometimes I feel alone, and then you speak to people like David and all these wonderful people at the March for Life, and you realize you are not alone. We have the right to be pro-life. Let's defend it. Back to you, Matt.
Thank you for that, Kevin. David, do you have any insights on this? Because you are the master of ceremonies for the big event.
Well, first of all, as Kevin said, I'm really excited that this isn't just a singular keynote, but that you're getting different perspectives on an issue that is incredibly current and timely for all of us. And I think there's a recognition that culturally right now, there are powerful forces that are not only trying to cancel the lives of preborn children, but they're trying to cancel our voice. They're trying to prevent us from being able to come together and share a voice on these critical issues, to articulate the dignity of human life, to articulate the need to help mothers in a time of pregnancy. So I think that not only will this be timely, this is going to be so empowering, because for each of us, when we feel like we're alone, there are forces that are trying to make us feel isolated because then we feel powerless. But when we come together knowing that we're not alone, when we unify our voices, they can no longer cancel our voices. And during this panel at the Rose Dinner, we're going to all be empowered and equipped to know what we can do to bring our voices together, to bring our efforts together, to protect more lives than ever before. So come to the Rose Dinner, yes, to be inspired, but come prepared to be empowered to go forth and save more lives and make a culture-shaping difference after the Rose Dinner. Matt?
Thank you for that. And I can't wait for this. I think this will make for some amazing TV. And again, what an amazing topic. Great panelists, great video submissions. I'm really looking forward to it. You can already register and buy your ticket for the Rose Dinner. Just go to marchforlife.ca. It's all available up on the website. Just buy a ticket. And once you do, you will receive a private link to the big show. So moving on, that is on May the 13th, in the evening of May the 13th. But on May the 12th, we will have the annual Candlelight Vigil. This will be a virtual event just like last year. And Debbie, can you tell us a little bit more about what people can expect to see for that event?
Well, the Candlelight Vigil, as you said, Matt, is virtual again this year. But that does allow for a lot of great performances, some nice big surprises that you might really want to tune in to see. We'll have some testimonials as usual and prayers. And this will all be hosted by James Pereira and Maria Brown. And it's going to be very lovely. And you know, our theme is you are not alone. You are not alone. I am always with you. That's sort of our theme for the Candlelight Vigil. Prayer and reflection, and some beautiful worship music. So I'm very looking forward to it. We're lining up all sorts of masses from across the country, hopefully, and prayer services from all sorts of different groups. And these will all be shown throughout the week, the March for Life week, from the 9th to the 14th, and including the usual National Mass for Life held at the Basilica, or the Cathedral, actually, in Ottawa. So I'm looking forward to that as well, Matt. It's going to be a lovely, prayerful event. Good way to start off the March for Life.
Thank you for that, Debbie. Debbie, can you actually expand on the theme of the Candlelight Vigil? You are not alone. I am with you always. And the importance of having prayer to be at the core of what we do.
Well, that's very true. Prayer is at the core of everything we do. We can't do anything without that. And this is a tough go. Abortion is a tough subject. There are a lot of people hurting from abortions, the obvious, the poor babies, but also moms who have lost their babies, dads who have lost their babies. It really is good for them to know that they are not alone, that they always have Jesus with them. And that's why I really love this. You are not alone. He is with us. I am always with you. And a foundation of prayer really helps everyone. There is hope and healing for everyone, no matter what's happened. Whether you've had an abortion or you've helped someone go for an abortion, there is hope and healing, especially through Jesus. And so it's really vital to know that, to know it's not over, to know that you can be redeemed and still come out and still support all of these people. So, and it's important for people to be praying at home, especially those who can't come. Please pray for us. Please pray for all the pro-life groups, well, in the world, Canada and the world, to really make a difference, to really impress upon people, to teach people day in and day out to change the culture, to value human life from conception right through to natural death. And, you know, we do that with prayer and relationships.
Thank you for that, Debbie. And I think everyone at the March for Life Organizing Committee, we all truly believe that we need God in this battle, right? Without Him, nothing will ever happen. We surrender completely to His will. And I believe that the Candlelight Vigil, the masses, the religious services, the prayer services are so fundamental to the success of restoring a culture of life here in this country and around the world. So we're hoping that you will join, tune in, you will pray with us, you will worship with us, and we will pray for the victims of abortion. We will pray for a culture of life. We will pray for mothers and fathers and children and seniors, all those who feel left alone and isolated, because we want them to realize that they are not alone. Even if people and their neighbors will abandon them, God will never abandon them, right? So I think that's the real mission behind the spirituality of the March for Life. I'm going to jump back to Kevin now, who will say a few words about our Life on Film Festival. I mean, we did these video, we screened several movies last year. It was a huge success. A lot of people were giving us some very positive feedback. So this year we decided to give them even more videos and more movies to watch. Kevin?
Thanks, Matt. Life on Film is a series of award-winning pro-life film screenings and conversations with the producers, including the highly anticipated Roe vs. Wade. You may have heard a lot about Roe vs. Wade. In fact, I think it just got released a few weeks ago. Another film we're premiering is called Divided Hearts of America, featuring NFL star Benjamin Watson. And a conversation with the producers of Gosnell, America's biggest serial killer. Really powerful discussion with Ann and fellow producers of that movie. Along with Hush, a liberating conversation about abortion and women's health with producer Drew Martin. Here's a look at the films.
We will hear arguments in Roe against Wade.
The 2021 National March for Life is pleased to present Life on Film, a series of award-winning pro-life film screenings on now, kicking off with the highly anticipated Roe vs. Wade.
I wanted to get abortion legalized across the country.
We're looking for a pregnant girl to challenge the abortion laws.
We'll give her a pseudonym, call her Jane Roe.
It's genius. That way no one will ever know about her past.
On April 25th, The Euthanasia Deception, a documentary on Belgium's 20-year experiment with euthanasia.
My mother was physically healthy. I mean, she was, yes, indeed. She was going in and out of depressions all her life, but is this a reason for euthanasia? Apparently it is.
On May 2nd, Obsessed, Canada's coercive diplomacy, how the West is funding abortion in Africa.
Why is it then that the Canadian government continues to fund organizations and special interest groups with hundreds of millions of dollars per year?
And on May 9th, the Canadian premiere of Divided Hearts of America, featuring NFL star Benjamin Watson.
In New York City, the home of Planned Parenthood, for decades more black babies have been aborted than born alive.
And on May 10th, Breaking Down Gosnell, America's Biggest Serial Killer, a conversation with the producers.
Nothing that man did that protects women or children, and you don't have to be a pro-life activist to see that.
On May 11th, Hush, a liberating conversation about abortion and women's health.
We're not talking about pro-life and pro-choice anymore. We're talking about very serious claims, like breast cancer, premature birth, and psychological damage.
And on May 16th, Blood Money, the business of abortion.
Life. We know it when we see it. We know it best when we see it taken away.
The 2021 National March for Life presents Life on Film, on now. Visit marchforlife.ca for more details.
The true silent minority. Who is speaking for these children?
Wow, what an incredible lineup of films for the National March for Life, Life on Film series. We spoke a little bit about Roe versus Wade. I had the opportunity to speak to director and actor Nick Loeb, who played abortionist turned pro-lifer Bernard Nathanson, whom some of you will remember, about his experience making the film and the struggles he faces in getting it into theaters. Really powerful discussion with Nick Loeb. This is the only film in the series that will require a paid ticket, $12.99 US, and will also be a fundraiser event for the National March for Life, and that's happening very soon, if not on now. Just make sure you check marchforlife.ca for details. And on Sunday, May 9th, we've secured the Canadian film premiere of Divided Hearts of America. $1 million budget isn't much for Hollywood, the promotion goes, but Benjamin Watson is hoping that it's enough to tell a story to bring empathy to a hot-button topic. Venturing onto a new field, the New England Patriots tight end has executive produced and partially self-financed Divided Hearts of America, the film, a look at the debate around abortion in America. And our own Debbie Duvall sat down with the producers of Gosnell, America's Biggest Serial Killer, as they discuss and preview some powerful clips from the film. Josie Lutke will be sitting down with Drew Martin, producer of Hush, a liberating conversation about abortion and women's health as part of the week as well, and Euthanasia Deception. Alex Schadenberg will also join us during the week. It's a powerful lineup of films, and we certainly hope that you will you'll join us. As again, other than the Roe versus Wade, all the rest of them are free of charge on marchforlife.ca. Back to you, Matt.
Thank you for that, Kevin. And David, I'm going to throw this back to you because I have this feeling that you were involved in the Divided Hearts of America documentary. Am I right?
Well, it depends on how you define that. But yes, I was there in the midst of some of the production of it. I was interviewed for a segment of the production with Ben Watson. They ultimately ended up not using it. So I ended up on the cutting room floor. But watching that whole project develop and knowing what they were trying to accomplish on that small budget in Hollywood terms, but also the big footprint of the impact they wanted to have, was amazing. And that's why I'm so encouraged when Kevin was sharing about all of these movies. It used to be, if you said pro-life movie, people's eyes would roll and they'd go, oh, this is going to be painful. It's going to be like, you know, ripping off a Band-Aid, having to watch some terrible low budget thing. But each of these movies is unbelievable and tells different parts of the story about the injustice of abortion, but also finding ways to tell it professionally, to reveal things we never knew about the Roe versus Wade decision, the landmark Supreme Court case in the United States that imposed abortion on all 50 states, or in the case of Benjamin Watson, what he did with Divided Hearts of America. Even watching as he was interviewing people on both sides of the aisle, being able to extract from them various different aspects of how this contentious debate has split a nation, and not just the United States of America, but North America and Gosnell as well. So each of these movies tells important stories. They're done professionally, they're done powerfully, and they're also done in ways that are not just to depress us about the problem, but instead to point us towards the solution, and that each of us, being not alone, together can be a part of solving this crisis of children dying in the womb, women being wounded, of a culture that's torn apart. Literally, these movies are going to help us know how we can help to bring light to the midst of the darkness.
Thank you for that, David. And We specifically scheduled most of these movies on a Sunday night so you could gather around with your family in your own living room and just watch these amazing movies. And then hopefully you can have a good, solid conversation about them with your family. Moving on now. So we've covered The Candlelight Vigil. We've covered The Rose Dinner. We've covered our Life on Film Festival. And now I'm going to pass this over to Josie, who's our CLC Youth Coordinator, who will talk a little bit about our youth conference that takes place on May the 14th. Josie?
Yes, I have the absolute privilege of organizing the youth conference on behalf of CLC Youth and Niagara Region Right to Life. Our theme this year is I Am With You, the 2021 National March for Life Youth Conference. And so we chose that theme to complement the You Are Not Alone theme of the March for Life, because in order for that to be true, in order for it to be true to say you are not alone, there have to be people like us standing up and saying, I am with you. So that is taking place as usual on the Friday following the march. So that's going to be May 14th this year from 3 to 8 p.m. Eastern. It's going to be online like a lot of these events are. It's going to be co-hosted by myself and CLC's Global Policy and Advocacy Advisor, Matea Murta. And I've talked a lot about how excited I am about our speaker roster. I'm finally able to reveal those names of our speakers. So we have Tony McFadden of Relationships Matter, Jay Watts of Merely Human Ministries, Joseph Backholm of the Family Research Council, and finally, Will Witt of PragerU. But instead of having me talk about this youth conference, why don't we watch the promo video for it?
What does it mean to be human? Well, that's a start. To be truly human, each one of us has to make a statement. A commitment to action where we reach out to tell those in need, you are not alone, I am with you.
What's up guys, my name is Will Witt and I'm super excited to be speaking to the National March for Life Youth Conference.
Join pro-life speakers Tony McFadden, Joseph Backholm, Jay Watts, and Will Witt for I Am With You, the National March for Life Youth Conference.
How do you heal from a heartbreak? What does it look like to wait with purpose in your singleness? And how do you prepare for marriage if you are single?
Are you prepared to impact the lives of the people around you for the cause of life?
I've gone across the country to tons and tons of campuses and on the street and talked to literally hundreds of people about abortion and other political and cultural issues. And so my talk is going to be giving you guys the skills so that you can use the right questions, facts, and everything else so that you can change people's minds on the issue.
I'm going to talk about why political issues are not actually about politics. All of this is going to help you become a much more effective communicator when we talk about the things that matter most.
The National March for Life Youth Conference, hosted by Campaign Life Coalition Youth and Niagara Region Right to Life. May 14th from 3 p.m. to 8 p.m. at marchforlife.ca. And thanks to our donors, the cost is free.
But in order to get the benefit, you have to be there. And in order to be there, you have to register. So do that at the link below, and we will look forward to seeing you on May 14th.
We will see you on May 14th.
I can't wait to see you guys there. Thanks.
So if you are as thrilled as I am about the prospect of attending the youth conference, then go to marchforlife.ca, click on events, and underneath events, you'll see youth conference. There you can register for free for this event. I encourage you to do so as soon as possible, and then encourage all of the other pro-life young people you know to register as well. In addition to that, I want to encourage you to keep watching our 100-day countdown videos. We have themes for each day of the week. If I can personally plug our Thursday Thank Youths, we've been featuring some tremendous pro-life youths who are involved in the movement. They've participated in all sorts of events like the March for Life, like Life Chain, like 4 Days for Life, and they're committed on a daily basis to bringing awareness to the human rights injustices of abortion and euthanasia. So all of that, again, it's available on marchforlife.ca. It's available on all of our social media platforms. So make sure that you're keeping up with that because there's some fabulous content that we're putting out on a daily basis.
Thank you for that, Josie. And just a big shout out to all the teachers who for so many years have been bringing groups of young people to our youth conference in Ottawa. This is the perfect opportunity to still keep them engaged get your class and your pro-life club, if there is one at your school, to register your students. It's all free, courtesy of Niagara Region Right to Life. And it's going to be such a great and educational and just inspiring event for all the young people out there. So I think that pretty much covers all the virtual events. But we actually haven't talked about the main event of the week, which is the rally on Parliament Hill and hopefully a march for life through the streets of downtown Ottawa. So now we don't really know what to expect with this ongoing pandemic, but we all believe that we need to be there in Ottawa. Even if only a few of us will show up, we need to have a presence there. Josie, can you tell us a bit about the importance of being on the Hill, even if it's only just the five of us and maybe David Bierite, who, I don't know, maybe he might fly in and then he'll have to stay in a hotel for 2 weeks. But nonetheless, why do we need to be there physically on the Hill?
So for over 50 years, our parliamentarians have failed in their duty to protect the human rights of all human beings from conception until natural death. In fact, just this year, they passed Bill C-7, which further extends the euthanasia regime. So this has resulted in thousands of people being killed through euthanasia and assisted suicide. Over 4 million have been killed by abortion since 1969. And it cannot be understated how much these evils plague our nation. They plague our nation way more so than COVID-19 does. So that's why we have to go to Parliament Hill, where our parliamentarians are, and hold them accountable. Because forget about one more year. We can't stand one more day of this. And so all of us as pro-lifers, we have a duty to call for legal protection for all human life. And so that's essentially why we're there on Parliament Hill. It doesn't matter to us how big the crowd is. It's an individual duty to stand for the most vulnerable.
Yeah, and let's remember that even during this whole COVID-19 pandemic, abortion was deemed an essential service, right? So, and that's just mind-blowing if you think about it. So we will be there. If you can't make it to Ottawa, we completely understand. And we know that Campaign Life Coalition, and we will be there on your behalf. But whoever does show up, we still plan on having a rally. We'll have some keynote speakers from the stage or from the grass. We don't know what to really expect. Even if it's just us and bullhorns, we're going to go back and make it old school, I guess. But we will be there. We're looking forward to seeing you, whether it's online or in person. We completely understand that many of you will not be able to make it to Ottawa this year for many reasons. We know that churches and schools will not be sending groups, which is understandable, but know that we will be there on your behalf. If you can't make it to Ottawa, know that the Eternal Word Television Network, EWTN, will be broadcasting the rally and the march live on their network. We will also be streaming their coverage on our Facebook and other social media platforms, so you can still tune in and be there in spirit by watching what's happening on the Hill. All right, so be sure to go to marchforlife.ca on a daily basis. We will be posting updates. Go there to register for the Rose Dinner, register for the youth conference, share the various content that we have online. So we're going to wrap up today, today's video update. I want to thank David Bierite for joining us today. Thank you so much for being part of this March for Life, David.
You bet. I'm excited. I can't wait. I'm looking forward to seeing everybody in May.
Thank you, Debbie. Thank you, Josie. Thank you, Kevin. On behalf of the National March for Life and Campaign Life Coalition, stay connected with us. Tune in to marchforlife.ca or youtube.com/marchforlifecanada. And we will leave you today with our National March for Life 2021 promotional video. Be sure to watch it and share it. Take care, everyone. God bless. And see you in Ottawa.
We are Canada's National March for Life, one of hundreds of marches held all over the globe, standing in solidarity with society's most vulnerable, with one voice, one message. Child in the womb, you are not alone. Pregnant mother, fearing an unknown future, you are not alone. Beloved senior, feeling isolated and afraid, you are not alone. On May 13th, Canadians will march peacefully on Parliament Hill and online
to implore our leaders to enact laws that protect life from conception until natural death. In these days of uncertainty, let us reach out and tell those most in need. You are not alone.